I've compiled a database of more than 500 computer power supplies, all with their respective efficiency numbers at 20, 40, 60, and 80 watt loads. And with this data, we can finally see, once and for all, what is the best power supply for your low idle home server. If you're in a rush, there's a Google Doc down in the video description, and you can see all the data by yourself. But if you want to know how we got here, why you would even want a 5, 6, 700 watt power supply to be efficient at a 20 watt load, and why not just use a Pico PSU, keep watching. Hi everyone, my name is Wolfgang, and in the past 2 years, I've been focusing on building super power efficient home servers. My ultimate goal is to build a machine that is quiet, compact, power efficient, but can still fit lots of storage, and has enough oomph for all of your day-to-day tasks. A power-efficient server needs a power-efficient power supply, and for many people who are running low-power home server hardware, when it comes to powering their systems, Pico PSU is often the obvious choice. Pico PSUs are small, fanless, very efficient at lower loads, and are perfect for systems that never draw more than 150 watts. But what if your system does? See, once you add hard drives into the mix, things get very interesting. A system with 4 hard drives can draw as much as 120 watts when starting up, since all the hard drives will spin up at the same time, but will still draw less than 20 watts at idle, as long as you spin those hard drives down. And the same goes for powerful CPUs. An i5-13500 will draw less than 1 watt at idle, but once you put some load on it, it can draw as much as 154 watts. And even though there are Pico PSUs rated for as much as 160 watts, the price for a power supply plus power brick combination for that kind of wattage kind of starts approaching the price for a decent ATX power supply, which, unlike Pico PSUs, are rated for more watts and come with way more power connectors for all of your devices. So, for a long time, the power-efficient home labbing community has been looking for a unicorn, an ATX power supply that is as power-efficient as a Pico PSU, but can still provide loads of power to your system when needed. And for some time, this unicorn has been the Corsair RM550X 2021. Discovered by a German Unraid user Mark Gutt, the RM550X reaches 81.4% efficiency at 20 watts, which is unprecedented for this price range. Or was unprecedented, until Corsair discontinued it. You can't buy the RM550X anymore, and the 2021 version is extremely rare, even in the used market.
Me too, kid.
So, ever since Corsair's unicorn bit the dust, I've been looking for a new low idle king, a sub-$100 ATX power supply with decent efficiency, even at 20 watts. And eventually, I stumbled upon the database of power supplies compiled by Cybernetics. Cybernetics is a company that provides power supply efficiency ratings. They run loads of tests on computer power supplies, and give them ratings based on efficiency and noise. However, what's important here is that Cybernetics publish full reports for each power supply that they test. They have more than 500 power supplies in their database, and if we look at the reports, each of them includes the one test that we're interested in the most, the 20 to 80 watt load test. However, as you might imagine, getting the 20 to 80 watt efficiency numbers for every power supply would take a very long time. Unlike some other metrics, these are buried deep in the full report PDF, so you'd have to click on the power supply, download the PDF, scroll down to the relevant page, write down the data, and then rinse and repeat about 560 times. But why spend hours doing the boring repetitive task if you can spend days automating it, and then spend some more days making a YouTube video about it? So I wrote a little Python script that would scrape the Cybernetics website, download the PDFs for every power supply tested, extract the low wattage efficiency numbers, find the lowest price that the PSU is available for, according to the German price aggregator, Geizhaus.de, and then put all of that in a spreadsheet. And so, without further ado, I present to you the PSU Low Idle Efficiency Database by Wolfgang's channel. This table contains all of the power supplies tested by Cybernetics as of early 2024, with data like form factor, efficiency rating, price, but most importantly, efficiency numbers at 20, 40, 60 and 80 watts load. So let's sort the table by 20 watt efficiency and dive right in. The first surprise that we get here is that the Corsair RM550X is not, in fact, the most efficient ATX power supply at 20 watts. This title goes to Seasonic Prime Titanium 750 watts. Obviously, the difference here is less than 1%, and the Prime Titanium costs almost 2 times as much as the RM550X. at least back when you could still, like, buy either of them. Moving down, we see yet another big surprise. Cooler Master MWE 400, which isn't even rated for 80 plus bronze, manages to get 81% efficiency at 20 watts load. If that still applies for the version 2, which is what you can currently buy online, at half the price of the RM550X, this is an amazing deal. The only caveat is that the MWE 400 is not modular, and doesn't have a 0% fan mode. The new Corsair RM750X Shift is also pretty power efficient and widely available, at a similar price as the RM550X had. Though keep in mind that the Shift series has the power connectors placed on the side, which might not be compatible with some cases. Finally, Cooler Master's MWE 550, 450 and 600 also seem to be pretty good when it comes to power efficiency and price. Unfortunately though, it's not looking good for the SFX power supplies. The most efficient SFX power supply is apparently made by a company called First Player, which I've personally never heard of before, and I also wasn't able to find any of their power supplies for sale on eBay or Amazon. Next up on the list is the Lianli PE750, with 77% efficiency. Unfortunately, it's also not being sold anymore. Finally, we got the Corsair SF850L, which can be had for a fairly reasonable price of $130. It's not as efficient as the RM550X, but when it comes to SFX power supplies, this is pretty much your best option. While we're on the subject of price though, let's talk about the ROI, or return on investment. Because, let's face it, at some point you're obviously hitting a point of diminishing returns, where you can spend more to get more efficiency, but it'll take decades to actually break even on your investment, like with those Seasonic power supplies at the top of the list. So, in order to demonstrate that, I've created this little tool which is called the ROI calculator, and I'm gonna show you how to use it. Let's say that we pay 30 cents per kilowatt, our server consumes 30 watts on average, and we run it 24 hours a day. We would like to buy a new power supply for our server, and we're choosing between a model that is 60% efficient at 30 watt load and costs $50, and the second model that is 80% efficient at 30 watt load but costs double, so $100. If we plug this data into the calculator, we'll see that it will take us 3 years, 2 months, and 2 days for the more expensive power supply to reimburse itself. And if you already have a power supply, well, if you already bought it, it's free, girl math. In that case, it will take you 6.5 years to break even on the new power supply. 6.5 years is a long time, but at the same time, people do run their home servers for 3, 6, and even 10 years, and the power supply is usually the part that is upgraded the least. Additionally, with higher loads, you will reach that break-even point faster. So at 40 watt load, 65% efficiency for the first PSU, and 85% for the second, it'll take 2 years and 4 months before the new PSU actually reimburses itself. At the same time, there's obviously a point past which it doesn't make sense to overpay for more efficiency. If we take the example of the $120 Corsair RM550X, and the $226 Seasonic Prime Titanium 750 watts, it will take us 274 years before we start seeing any return. Now, one more thing that I wanted to mention is that lower load efficiency is not the only thing you should look at when buying a power supply. Modularity, noise, long-term reliability, all those things should also be taken into account. Every PSU in the database has a link to its respective cybernetics report, and you should also look at the reviews from trustworthy tech outlets if you're not sure about your purchase. Finally, I am planning to update the document regularly and make sure that any new power supplies tested by Cybernetics also make it in spreadsheets. I also have no plans of putting the doc behind a paywall or anything like that. It's gonna remain free forever. However, if you want to support my efforts, you can use the link in the doc to buy your new power supply. I earn a small commission from every purchase, and you get a new power-efficient PSU, so I'd say it's win-win. Once again, all credit for the technical data in the spreadsheet goes to Cybernetics, and there are links to full reports for every power supply in the database. That's gonna be it for this video though, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as usual, I would like to thank my patrons, James Eppington, Kevin Ware, Alessandro Calori, Carlos Bonilla, David Love, Jubastica, Matthew K, Robot Stream of Crypto, and everyone else supports this channel. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.